Now, what I have to do is take all the journal entries that I recorded and transfer those over to the T accounts. This part of the problem is very easy. In fact, it's very tedious and very repetitive to do this. But it's important because by transferring those journal entries, it's going to help me balance the accounts and figure out how much is in each one. So I have to do this very methodically. And really, the only danger of making a mistake on this is just if you get in a hurry and put something in the wrong place. Remember, every time one of these accounts was debited, we're going to put that amount on the left side. Every time it was credited, we're going to put that amount on the right side. And provided that our journal entries were correct, eventually we'll see this how this pans out. But if the journal entries that we did were correct, and hopefully they are, we will be able to see that when we get to part three. So to do this, I'm going to transfer my journal entries. So if I go back and look at my journal entries, that very first entry, I debited cash $200,000 and debited office equipment $25,000. So cash, I'll put a debit of $200,000, and office equipment, I'll put a debit of $25,000. And then what else did I do? I also credited capital for $225,000. So I'll go down here to capital, but notice the $225,000, I'm going to put that on the credit side. Remember, the debits go on the left, the credits go on the right. So it's that easy. I'm just going to transfer everything. It's tedious, but it is an important part of accounting. So then I debited prepaid rent, $5,600. So I'll bring that over, $5,600. Then I credited cash, $5,600. So I'll back up to cash and put a credit for $5,600. Main thing is to go through this methodically. Don't leave one out. If you leave one out, things aren't going to balance out. Then we debited office equipment, $15,000. So another $15,000 on office equipment. Then we debited office supplies, $2,000. So a debit, $2,000, office supplies. Then we credited accounts payable, $17,000. Well, accounts payable is going to be all the way down here on the liabilities, and that was a credit for $17,000. Then we debited cash, $10,000. So I'll debit cash, $10,000. Then we credited service revenue, $10,000. So all the way down here on service revenue, $10,000. Now I probably do this a little faster than you will at the beginning, but that's just because I'm so used to doing this and I pretty much know exactly where to look for all the accounts. Probably take you a little bit longer because you'll have to sort of search around and figure out where the accounts are. But I just pretty much remember what order they were in. Then we had a debit to accounts receivable, $5,000. So accounts receivable, debit, $5,000. Then we had a credit to service revenue, $5,000. So there's the service revenue credit, $5,000. Then we had a debit to accounts payable, $17,000. Then we had a credit to cash, $17,000. Then we had a debit to prepaid insurance, $7,000. And a credit to cash, $7,000. So I'll credit cash on that side, $7,000. Then we had a debit to cash for $5,000. So debit, $5,000 cash. Then a credit to accounts receivable for $5,000. So I'll put that on the credit side. Then we had a debit to accounts receivable, $10,000. A credit to service revenue, $10,000. Then a debit to withdrawals, $3,000. First time we've used that one. Credit to cash, $3,000. Cash is all the way up here at the top. In fact, cash gets used more than any other T account. Debit to office supplies, $500. I'm going to change this title because I just realized that office supplies is misspelled. Then we have a credit to accounts payable, $500. That's a liability down here, so that's credit side, $500. And then we have a debit to utilities expense, $1,000. That's all the way down here at the bottom, $1,000 debit. And then finally, a credit to cash, $1,000. So all the way back up here on cash, $1,000. So that completes at least posting all the journal entries to the T accounts. And like I said, that's a very important part. It's just a little bit tedious and time consuming. But as long as you do that in a very detailed way, you'll be in good shape.